I have been asked many times what modifications I done in my tool. So in this video I will show you what modifications I done in my Leatherman Charge Plus G10. This is my everyday carry tool. It's not done for commercial purpose. It's done for my personal needs. My personal needs were defined for after I used this TTI charge TTI for 8 or 9 years. So the whatever I identify here that I need, it was transferred or made from new on this one. So I will start with the lanyard strap. This is the normal lanyard strap I'm using. It's a tool that I will talk about in another video. Actually, I will talk about lanyards in different video. This is a suspension clip. It's not very good for multi-tool so heavy. And it can be detached like this with a small carabiner here, away from here. I also have a lanyard, which is actually a little bit better than this one. It's also have that tool, that artificial fingernail, and it's also have small carabiners for the multi-tool. For the multi-tool and also for the flashlight. So I will talk about this in a different video. So the first things I will talk about is the driver bits. I have 4 driver bits, 5 including the one which is inside of the tool. There are 2 on this side on the magnetical supports, which they can be removed. These were designed in a Saturday morning sometime, I don't remember. Yeah, and they can attach to the pocket knife like this. They are guided by this this part here. And these cutouts here. If you want to use the plier, you have to remove one because otherwise they will crush, as you can see. So you have to remove one, and the pliers will work normally. I usually don't use this too much. I don't wear them all the time on my pocket knife, on my multi-tool. Instead, I am carrying this all the time. You can see they are quite used, actually. These are staying here because embedded in these scales are 4 magnets, 2 on this side, 2 on this side. Strong enough not only to keep this but also when these are removed they can keep the multi-tool attached to some metallical part. So I have this, I can take them out. Now the scales. The scales are 3D printed by myself. Well, designed and 3D printed by myself. They are not the final version. At the moment, they have the same shape with the original ones. The next version will have an aluminium reinforcement inside, and they will be the shape of the scales from the original TTI model, which will have this hump a little bit lower, so actually the profile will be a line tangent with this circles here, which will be a little bit lower here. The scales are 3D printed in ABS, glow-in-the-dark ABS. The white part is glow-in-the-dark. The black part is also ABS, but not glow-in-the-dark. The scales are on this side. They have my name. Some people ask me, why did I put my name on it? Well, if you forget the tool somewhere, people will know who's the owner of that tool, and maybe they will know you. Yeah, so it will be nice if somebody find it to know whose tool is this. I also worked in a workshops where a lot of people have Leathermans. And it was very hard to distinguish if you are leaving your multi-tool on the table, to distinguish from the first view if it's your tool or somebody else's tool. Like this, I will never have problems. On the scales, if I can focus correctly, there are some bumps. These bumps are done for the grip. They are not so aggressive if you don't put force on the scales. So in this way you can slide the tool in a sheet or in a pocket very easy. Yeah. But if you grip the tool harder, they are very grippy. Yeah. So if you put pressure on the scales, they are very grippy because of this. And they are very good when you have the hands wet, you have some oil on your hand. They are very good. They will not slip away from your hand. Also, speaking about oil, usually the 3D printed parts, they can absorb between the layers a lot of liquids like oil or something. That way these scales, they actually have two coats of lacquers over them, so they will not be prone to absorb any liquids. On this side, these two scales are actually a little bit thicker than the other ones, because they have embedded on each scale, they have two magnets embedded, and also they have this slot, so it will accommodate the bits. So we'll keep them not to move left and right. And in this way, I can carry the bits without the concern that I will lose them. I have these bits for almost 2 months. You see that it's there, weared out. And I never have problems with them coming out. It's actually very hard to take them off. Also, these magnets are strong enough that it can keep the tool itself on some metallical surface. I will demonstrate. Here is the big Bobo, the Leatherman Surge. And I can lift the tool only on the magnetic part. So I don't know if it's visible. The magnets are strong enough to keep the tool. The future modifications, they will also, I will put underneath of this screws some features which will replace the spring washers. Maybe I can keep the screws tight without any Loctite. As I said, the profile here will be different, will be very similar with the original TTI profile, so not this one, but the older one. And this is all about the scales. Also, the washers here are 3D printed. They are also just temporary 3D printed. They are not the last version. I will explain in a minute why did I print new washers. You will see that they have some features here. They have to accommodate some features here. So this is all about the scales. So now the tools itself. First of all, I removed the file because I wanted the file to be used outside of this tool. It will be better. And instead of the file, I put a Victorinox scissors, which I think they are the best in class. Actually, these scissors, they were staying on the other tool on TTI, and when I start to do this, I transfer them to this. These scissors, they have a lot of use from my tool. Actually, these scissors and the serrated blade, they are the most used tools in this multi-tool. That I use them almost daily. On our side, the rest of the tools are the normal tools for a charge S30V blade, normal blade, the saw, and the serrated blade. As I said, this serrated blade is seen a lot of use on the other, on the TTI, is seen a lot of use because it stays sharper for longer. And in my opinion, it can be used in more occasions than the straight blade. So I can cut bags, I don't know, a lot of things. So in my TTI, this was used a lot. So on our side, that's are all the tools. If we go inside, on this side here is just the normal bit driver and the can opener. But on this side here, I will show you what for what I use this tool actually. I have a rebar hole. I bought a rebar to replace the pliers on the TTI many years ago, because the Charge Plus and Wave Plus, they were not on the market yet. So I used on this, I used the rebar heads. Actually, the rebar heads, they are looking much more stronger than the Charge and Wave Plus heads. So, if I close this, so this is the all from the rebar. Normally, this doesn't allow for the knife to be closed completely. I have to shave off a little bit of this spine here, but for the moment, I'm not concerned with that. Next tool. This is the straight screwdriver. I sharpened this, if you see the profile. I sharpened this to be a chisel. And also the small screwdriver I modified. Come on, focus. So the small screwdriver I modified to be a hook, to hook a lot of, to pull through a hole some wires or some lanyard wire or anything like this. I needed a lot of this tool, and I have the idea that just to cut a channel in this and to make it a hook. On the other side, it's actually sharpened, so it can be a reamer. Okay, so if I close this, on the inside I have only these tools. So I, as I told you, the white and black washers are also 3D printed in order to accommodate few things like a toothpick, which is fitting too well to a Victorinox toothpick. I remodel this and I can even 3D print them if I need them. A Victorinox pen. This is a pressurized pen, so it can write up or upwards, and it's resisting a lot in time. If you don't have the pressurized pen, they might dry very close, or you can find out that they are leaking. So the pressurized pen, it's better. It will cost a little bit more, but I managed to fit the Victorinox pressurized pen, so for me it's very nice like this. Tweezers, Victorinox tweezers. This have to be, I am planning to cut them a little bit in this corner, so I'll have a flat surface here and very sharp edges on the other side. These are Victorinox tweezers. I don't have Leatherman's tweezers. They are a little bit wider than the washers here, so that's why I had to modify a little bit the handles here, just to cut a little bit of channel here inside. And also I have a sewing needle that is have a end with a 3D printed part. This is for using as a needle or a reset pin, mostly for a reset pin use. I don't have a slot anymore where I can put the pocket clip, because as I told you, I use this a lot with the pocket clip, but I didn't like it, because the pocket clip, when you use it as a pocket clip, it's okay. When you use the knife normally like this, it's in your way, and for me it was very disturbing. When you try to cut something, you catch these handles very well, and when you make some movement, this is starting to move under your hand, making you very unsure on what you are doing. So I didn't like the pocket clip. I have a lot of them, so that way in this model I didn't left any space for the pocket clip. Instead I have done the four spaces for the other mini tools. So this is my pocket tool. These are the modifications I done on it. For the moment, they are not definitely for me. There will be some other modifications at the moment. These are the tools which are inside or modified, including the lanyards. I forget, I don't know if I said that, but the white part on the scales, it's glow in the dark. I don't remember if I said that at the beginning. This is all what I modified. I hope you like it. I hope it will inspire you for whatever you want to do. And let me know in the comments if you like it, what you will do different, and so on. See you later.